Hey, what's up guys, it's Megaphone, and if you clicked on this video, it's because you want to smash Druids and Warriors as Rogue Mage in Arena. I'm gonna be doing some commentary over some matches I've played recently, with some good openers, some bad openers, some general theory about, you know, the matchup. And I'm also gonna give you some context about the matchup, and going over my gear now, just so you know where I'm coming from. I'm a pretty geared mage, and I'm just here to help you guys out. Alright, so I'm going to do something new around here. I'm going to do a matchup tier list for Rogue Mage, and I'm going to continue to update it as the channel continues to grow. So it's no secret, Druid Warrior is a pretty darn good matchup for Rogue Mage. My top two tips would be to learn how to control and play against the Warrior. You never want them smacking your rogue, and you want to be able to do a clean chain of CC on the druid and just communicate with your rogue buddy. That's your two-step to success. Alright, this is the most basic opener everyone should know. You start with Frost Nova, and you go into the polymorph on the warrior. If they're really good, they might reflect you here, but they usually, at lower levels, trinket. And then you can get blinded, and you just boom, all into that druid. You time your counter spell and garrote well, druid just dies. Alright, here's another example of a great opener. The warrior comes, charges on me. It's no big deal. We're just gonna walk away in Frost Nova. And I'm telling you, it takes a while for warriors to learn the patience to not freak out here. This guy trinkets before the Nova even ends. I just sheep his dumbass. He doesn't get the reflect, and we're dominating his buddy, and the warrior's just left out of the match the entire time. One important part here, if you rewind this clip, my rogue is gouging for me, so I can get up there and kill the druid. Super important, and we're gonna do some more gouge examples coming up soon. Alright, so I'm out of stealth for this one. The warrior's gonna get a charge on me, and my rogue opens with the cheap shot and gouge like normal. This warrior cannot stop my polymorph, I am too swift for him, and it's just absolute pound town on the druid. So the warrior has no trinket here, we're gonna get a sheep on him, and my rogue decides to do a crazy offensive blind to end the game. Just watch, it's coming up in a second here, but it doesn't pay off, and we kinda gotta dance around a little bit more. So here's one aspect of the matchup, just keeping the warrior frozen. If he ever attacks you, you can get frostbitten, you can Frost Nova him. Keeping him rooted and out of the way is super key, even if the opener isn't like perfect. Alright, we got another Invis start here, and I get a great Frost Nova opening. In this one though, the warrior does spell reflect me, and I do have to use my trinket. It's a little bit messier. The druid's a little bit better kiting around the corner. I still get the sheep on the warrior, and then it's chase time on the druid. Look at him, I mean, he gets a great war stomp, he gets a good cyclone on me, his warrior's out to play, my rogue's gonna blind him, the warrior's gonna trinket. And that's what I'm thinking this entire time. I'm looking at the warrior's trinket, I'm looking at his DRs, I just want to keep him out of the field. He has no Nova DR, hit him with that Nova. My rogue was patient, we got the full second kidney shot, 6 seconds, and it's just over with a nice chain of spells and counterspell, you know? And if it ever comes down to this where your rogue's almost about to die, try and save him. Alright, so it wouldn't be fair if I didn't include a loss in here. Let me show you a match where a couple little things going wrong could screw your win. So the opener went pretty fine here. I Nova the warrior, I give him a sheep, he uses his trinket, and we're chasing the druid, right? The dream opener for the comp. But you'll see that we let this druid slip away, and I don't pay as much attention to CCing the warrior as I should. So, you know, letting this run out. Here comes the sheep in a second, and I toss a second sheep on him, even though I know the blind is coming up, that's a little bit of a flub. But here the druid starts to get away. He's almost about to die, and I let him charge me, and he slips away from our fingertips, and lo and behold, here comes the warrior, because I was so focused on getting this guy dead, I'll let the warrior get some openers on us. And once again, we're like blind with rage trying to get this guy that we're not playing. I'm not playing at my tippy top. I get spell reflected. I gotta use my trinket. I let my rogue get opened on again. You know, it's my duty to keep that guy in place. And also, that bear charge. That's something that's gonna lose your guys some games. Bear charging, your rogue can't, you know, shadow step in, sprint in, and get the extra little bit of damage, and then, you know, tunnel visioning, trying to get the win instead of playing nice, calm, control. Okay, this one's great. This is just a little bonus. So I have this super long duel with this warrior who I kind of wasn't kiting too properly, but also I knew I was the mage and he couldn't really do too much to me. As soon as the druid comes out, it's good stuff. Anyways, I'm just going to let this duel play out with the commentary.
Waiting for Drew to let you dueling. You okay?
Yeah. Take your time. Gouge him and all that good stuff.
Go.
Yeah, fuck these druid teams. Give us our free points.